Instagram, YouTube, what it do? It's your boy Manny Riot coming at you with the ish they should have taught us. This week, as you can see, I'm starting off with a shout out to my crew. Shout out to the lineage which we stem from as I competed at Jiu Jitsu World League yesterday. This is us showing up right here. We got Big Moose, we got my sister, we got myself. And it was a little bit weird. Things didn't go according to plan, but I ended up coming out with a W, and so I'm pretty stoked on that. As I got there and I was set to compete, I was scheduled to be in a no-gi tournament, right? I walk in, as you can see here, and it'll give you a little vantage point of what I walked through. But as I got there, I'm sitting in line in the bullpen, and everyone that starts lining up behind me starts showing up in a gi, and it's pretty weird. And so I asked the lady, and she said, oh no, your other no-gi competitors will show up soon. They never showed up, and I start talking to the competitors that are there, and they said, yeah, like, I remember seeing a 10th Planet guy in our bracket. And I was like, we're a no-gi school, we don't do gi. So I went and spoke to the coordinators, and as they check their information, they find that they accidentally put me in a gi match. So I had to like figure out what I was gonna do. Was I gonna compete in a gi? I haven't trained in a gi in like 8 months, but I do have a gi in my backpack that I always keep there in case anyone ever wants to roll gi with me for fun. So I ran upstairs, told Moose that I wasn't gonna be able to compete in no-gi because there was no one in my division, and that I was gonna compete in gi. So I go grab the gi, put it on, run downstairs, and I end up waiting right there on the side for a little bit because they don't have me all set up, right? But as soon as it's go time, like, I'm ready to go. I run on to the mats and get it going, right? This here is my first match. As you can see, it was kind of like a stalemate. We were kind of trying to see who could get the inside position. I haven't done gi in a while, but I know I'm trying to get in that collar tie, right? Well, after I take him down, I try to go for like a weird modified bow and arrow, but can't get it. And so here you'll see me, I know I'm in my Z guard, I try to go in for that electric chair, but my lockdown wasn't deep enough, and I realized that. So I end up letting it go, try to go into like X guard, can't really get that, but his weight is too far forward on his hands, so I know I can just back out, and I try to hurry up and get on top of him so I can still have dominant control. Ultimately, they start us over. We go in the middle. He tries a pull guard, but I've had that happen to me before, so I know I just got to push that knee, get through, and get that crossface up top, right? He's got that hand like on my gi pretty strong, so I know I can break that down if I break the grip and go for an Americana or a Kimura, which is exactly what I do here. Here you'll see the fuse switched because Stefano was on this side as well, and so you see that left. His right arm right there is just high up on my gi, right? So I'm just gonna break that grip, and as I break it, I press it down to the mat, go for Americana, game over. Now, I was stoked because this is my first gi match in forever, so I was really happy. Here I am in the final, again trying to assert my control, trying to gain dominance, and I know I'm looking for a snap down, right? See, boom, there you go, got it. Try to get control of that head and arm. I bring him down. Now, last time before I competed, Jeremiah was clear to let me know that I could talk to the refs and let him know what I got. So you see me here talking to the ref and pointing to the fact that I have a chin strap on that other hand because I'm going to go for a guillotine to Dar's combo. So when they restart us, I wanted to make no sure that we have that. After I go from that, I end up getting into mount. I put that knee up high after I gift wrap here, bring him over to the back. And once I have his back, I'm going to try to get a triangle from the back, which I don't end up successfully doing, but you'll see me use this leg right here on top to bring it over his arm, and that's going to be my triangle leg, right? If I switch him over, but he's got a good grip right there that won't let me get through, so I bring him back. And right here I'm thinking, you know, I'm up 9 points to nothing. I could actually go for the truck. So you see a little bump of the knee right there, but he starts turning. So as he starts turning, we've done this before. I put my shin to the back of his head and I'm trying to roll through a swim through to get that arm bar. But he's fighting it pretty tough. So you see me there again, readjust. Now I'm trying to crank it to see if I could go for an ultra Kimura. So you see, he fights that back again. So there, I'm gonna try to roll him again. then I end up getting the armbar. It was a good tournament. You see me throwing that 1-0 to my teammates. Damn, I love my gym. I love what we represent. I love what we do there. You see that 10th Planet Santa Barbara shirt under my gi? I mean, all my no-gi attire underneath that 10th Planet represent, baby, baby. It's crazy what competition does, man. It's so mental. It's all in your mind. It's all in your head. This tournament, everything that could have gone wrong to, like, start off, did, right? And I ended up victorious. That's kind of, like, how it is that I view my approach. Things aren't always going to go the way you want them to. Things aren't always going to go down the path of what you expect. But you got to roll with the punches and do what you do.
Life, baby.
Yeah. Hey, show us a goal. Show us a goal.
Santa Barbara, under who? Jeremiah Vance, baby.
Yeah. It didn't go out the way I wanted to, you know. I was sick all week. I didn't get to train at the competition. I felt completely down. I had to go outside, sit down, lay down in the sun, and try to get myself right. I ended up laying down, and Crenshaw and Slauson by Nipsey Hussle came on my iPod, and that just got me cranked up and ready to go. You know, you got to keep going. You got to keep doing you. Find the groove somehow, and that's what happened, and that's what I did. Thank you for all your support. Much love. See you soon. 10th Planet Jiu-Jitsu, baby.